two chapters, that is motion in a straight line and motion in a line. Okay. Today in unit 5, that is chapter 5, we will discuss laws of motions. In that we will discuss the Newton's laws of motion. But this is all basic concept. This Newton's law is all basic concept on the concept of the force. We already discussed in the previous, that is school level, the force. What is the force? Okay, the force is nothing but force, a physical quantity, and the force is physical quantity and which causes the motion of the object or which opposes the motion of the object. For example, body is force. If I consider this chalk, okay, this causes motion of body, or which opposes the motion in a body. I consider chalk, okay. If I apply to this force, if I apply force to this object, which causes the motion. Or if it is in a motion, then if I apply force like this and which opposes the motion, it means it comes to rest. For example, if I consider this as the chalk, then then it causes the motion of this object. If I apply force on this, which causes the motion of the object. And similarly, if this is in motion and if I force like this and it opposes the motion of the object. Okay, in a high school level we study about the force. Then some examples, if I kick the ball, then due to that force the ball gets the motion. When ball is there, if you force apply our ball of position change. It means the force can also be said that it is the pull or push of the object which changes the position of the object. Which changes position of object. It means if a body is, you consider this body, it is initially rest, okay? Then if I apply force on this body, then the position of this body is here. If I apply force on this body, then the position gets from here to here. That force is also said that this is the pull or push of the object, and which changes the position of the object. Now the object the position of object from here to comes here. Or the force can also be said that which causes the motion of the body. It is initially in the rest of it. Then if I apply force on this, then which causes the motion of the object. Okay. Or which opposes the motion of the object. Even body in move, then I apply force here, then which opposes the motion of the object. That is the force. In day to day life, we use the force. For example, one body object position change, force apply. Then ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ಡೇ ಟು ಡೇ ವಾಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ, ಹೌದಾ? ದೆನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ನಾವು, ಅರ್ತ್ ನಾವು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕ್ತೇವೆ, ಹೌದಾ? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ ನಾವು. ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಷನ್, ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ಸ್ ಲಾಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆಲ್ ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ಸ್ ಲಾಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ತ್ರೀ ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಷನ್ we use the concept of the force. Then in force there are two types. we already discussed the force, okay? In that, the force is nothing but which causes the motion of the object or which opposes the motion of the object. In contact force, here also a body which causes the motion of the object or opposes the motion of the object with contact of a object. With contact of the object. It means, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಇಫ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್, ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕಾಸಸ್ ದ ಮೋಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್, ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಎನಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಹೌದಾ, ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ by contacting with this base, it moves, okay? And this is also a friction force, okay? Yeh nagasti rough agar. The friction is nothing but in next class we will discuss about in detail about friction. Just the friction is nothing but rubbing between the two objects anta hetuna. Similarly, if I consider this as the base and this as the object, then by contacting with this base only, this object moves. Then that is called as the contact force anta hetuna. Or idu now ground athwa on base anta consider madide andre, if consider this as the chalk and this object moves, or which is the along with this base or along with this ground, then that is called as the contact force. And another thing, for example, contact force means if I consider ball, hoda, then if I hit that, then that is contact with the earth and that ball moves. That is the contact force. Next here, that is the second force, that is the action at a distance. Action at distance. Action at a distance means this is also a force, and here it is the opposite of the contact force. In contact force, the object moves or the object moves when we apply the force and contact with the base or that the ground anta. And similarly here, action at a distance means which do not contact with the object or which do not contact with the base. It means in case of charge or in case if I consider a magnet, how done? Then we know that magnet, there is a north pole and south pole. How done? North pole and south pole. Then without contacting, how done? We also know that north pole and south pole are attract each other. Then this is one magnet and this is another magnet, north and south. Then without contacting, if I held this near to this, now even bar magnet in a inner bar magnet near is there, north pole and south pole contact aagtava. Now then, if consider this as one bar magnet and this is a another bar magnet, this is the north pole and this is the south pole. Without contacting, if I have these near to each other, then this north pole and south pole get attracts. That is the action at a distance. Okay, there are two types of a force. One is the contact force and another is the action at a distance. In case of contact force, there is a contact with the any base. The when we apply